2023.
Women have the power to transform this world. We can end crime and violence if we all agree to do one thing: share. Let's share our wisdom, share our time, share our talents, share our finances, but most of all, let's share our love. This is the Female Solution. Join me, Naima Latif, every morning, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Central Standard Time, as we bring you stimulating discussions about the issues affecting our lives. If you're listening online at www.blogtalkradio.com/the-female-solution, press the blue button that says follow and get our daily topics every morning directly to your email and your smartphone.
Hi, I'm Naima Latif, executive producer of the Female Solution Radio Show. We invite you to call in 515-605-9325 and participate in this daily think tank as we examine the challenges we face and develop solutions that restore peace and harmony. We are global transformers, changing the world from the way it is to the way it should be. We are one. Wherever we live on this earth, we are one human family. On behalf of our team of radio hosts, I'd like to extend a greeting to all the members of our family, whenever and wherever you may be listening around the world. To our family in China, ni hao. In
ni
India,
hao.
Namaste. In
namaste.
Japan, konnichiwa. In Korea,
annyeonghaseyo.
In Russia, zdravstvuyte. In Germany, guten tag. In Poland, dzień dobry. In France, bonjour. In Spain, hola. In Italy, ciao. In Egypt, ahlan wa sahlan. In Ghana, akwaba. In Nigeria, peleo. In South Africa, sawbona. In Senegal, nangadef. In Kenya, jambo. In Israel, shalom. In Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Saudi Arabia, assalamu alaikum. Greetings, and may peace be upon you all.
And Sadnam to all my yogi friends. Welcome, welcome to February 17, 23. Boy, this month is going fast. We're going to be in the Pisces really soon, and on Sunday I'm going to go into the Pisces astrology on soul purpose healing. But today, on February 17, 7, 8, 9, 10, let's see, plus 7, we're in an 8 today. The number 8 is circulating around the globe, around the planet, around the cities, around us every day today, because it's February 17, 2023. So welcome, everybody, to health and well-being. There's a lot going on in the United States. Whoa, explosions everywhere. People are breathing toxic air now, and the fish are dying. The lakes are getting more polluted than ever. So we want to bring you some valuable information today and knowledge about how you can protect this temple from all these toxins. We can do it. This body was made to resist all the toxins in the planet, but there's some things we have to do to tune up this temple. This is a sacred temple, a advanced biological computer. And we just time for a tune-up for this computer with all the toxic waste spills going on. We got to tune up the temple and prepare for what could happen. We're not saying anything could come into your neighborhood, but right now, Ohio and Arizona, of all places, Tucson had a big toxic explosion from a truck of some kind, and orange gases or something, smoke flowing in it. So no fear, no fear, no fear, just preparation. And what do we do here? We fly. We first love yourself. First love yourself, and then you don't have to worry about others. And then we pray and meditate on health and well-being with Viyahta. I strongly believe in prayer 24/7 sometimes. I don't wait to get on my knees at night or at a certain time of the day. I'm on ready alert to pray when things come to my attention. So yesterday I had a wonderful, wonderful time at my grandchildren's school. It's Black History Month. So their school put on a wax museum tour of all the Black, not all, but many Black American greats in the history of this country. It was beautiful, beautiful. There were children, not only my grandchildren were participating, they were standing in front of their little display and talking about the person they represented. But the children of other races were doing the same thing. There were Hispanic children, Caucasian children, all Black children, all presenting a Black American as a prominent, influential figure in the history of the country. So stop hating on Florida. Every school district has the opportunity to really shine this month and teach our children about the great things that Black Americans have done for this country. So let's all participate in your own neighborhood, in your own schools. Make sure those schools are lifting up Black Americans this week so that we are no longer ignorant. That's right. This is all about removing ignorance from the planet. So while we are preparing our bodies for any explosion or toxic future, let's do some joint rolling, because joint rolling is where it starts. First, loving ourselves. And I always have some great music in the way of Time for Healing. This is a song by The Sounds of Blackness, and I just love the words and the music. So while you're rolling your joints, think about the words to this music, and the solution they bring is love. Love is the solution. So let's get ready to, first of all, let's just take a deep breath. Breathe in through your nose, and then open up your belly, your navel area, push that navel, and then exhale through your mouth or your nose, whatever feels comfortable for you. Breathing in through the nose, hold it, and exhale through your nose or your mouth, whatever is comfortable. Breathe in through your nose, hold it in, and exhale. One more time, breathe it, big inhale, hold it, and exhale. Woo, I hope that inhale, exhale exercise is bringing you more balance, calm, and peace in your body. But let's fly now. First, love yourself by rolling some joints, and we're going to start with our neck. Then we go to our shoulders forward and back. And then we're going to get on our backs, kick those legs up, and roll those ankles and wrists around in each direction. And following that, we'll roll our legs around to get our knee joints lubricated both directions. And then we get on our side and roll the whole leg around so we can lubricate these hip joints, keep them nice and fluid, with synovial fluid. So let's do it. I'm going to start the music, Time for Healing, and we're going to start with rolling our necks around.
Now a foolish pride, but pain is a secret that is hard to cover, and it's the reason we mistreat each other.
To bring our vagus nerve into balance and energize the whole body. When you do this technique, you energize your whole body because the vagus nerve is the trunk communicating element. And squeeze, take those hands, squeeze and release. Place them on the back of the neck, squeeze and release. And you should feel that all the way down to your toes. Squeeze and release. Squeeze and release. Squeeze and release. Woo! Loving on yourself feels great. Feels great to show love to yourself. That's what we do here. Loving ourselves first, and that love can flow out to others. All right, let's just squeeze our shoulders a little. Pat down the arms, under the arms. Get that lymphatic drain going. Pat under there, both arms. Energizing your lymphatic system under the arms. Right in the middle of your chest is your thymus gland. Give that a pat. Always good to pat on your thymus gland these seasons of toxic air and toxic chemicals. Patting there. And then don't forget to pat around the breast. That's where your lymph glands are get clogged often. They can contribute to breast cancer and other diseases. Even grab the breast, love them, give them a massage, and then take your time to go around your navel and just rub around your navel. Get those microbiomes activating and loving on your mind. And then just take the time to go right back here to where your kidneys are and your adrenal glands. Give them a love pat back there, adrenal glands and kidneys. Love you, love you. Thank you. Thank you for all the work you're doing. And we are ready. We're ready now. Woohoo! Give yourselves a hand. We are ready now to get into preparing your body for the next toxic explosion. Guess what? Could be in your backyard. We never know. But you can be ready for times like this. And we are in some really tumultuous, crazy times right now. We don't know what's going to happen next. Rumors of war and all that. We've heard it before. But we're going to be prepared here on health and well-being, because the key is to have a strong mind, body, and spirit. And that's what we do. So let me transfer. I'm going to take my laptop and go to my computer or my station in the studio. I'm back in the studio. Yay. Here we go. In the studio. Hope everybody is doing well. How is everybody out there? I am on four platforms this morning. First of all, I'm in the Blog Talk Radio studio. Welcome all you loving friends and supporters. And I have several in the studio already this morning. Thank you for joining me. I'm also on Facebook Live on my private personal channel, Viyahta or Viyahta Robinson. And I'm on Soul Purpose Healing Facebook page. And I'm also on YouTube this morning. I'm back on YouTube. And just hoping I don't say anything that would censor me, but it just might flow out. You never know. But so we're here today to talk about preparation. In the news, all these one major explosion in Palestine. When I saw the headlines, I thought, oh my goodness, Israel is having an explosion over there, a train wreck in Palestine. No, it's in the United States. It's in Ohio. There's a city called Palestine, and it's actually near Philadelphia or Pittsburgh. I mean, a lot of communities could be affected by this train wreck that just occurred, a train wreck. Can we say train wreck? Have we been in a train wreck for the last 3 years? So if you haven't been preparing your body after the last three-year train wreck, hello, the universe is speaking to us in the year 2023, number seven, to get ready. Number seven to me represents divine revelation, divine healing, divine manifestation. Powerful, powerful year for us to get whatever we need, whatever we want to manifest. And here's a riddle for you. What do John Legend and John Legend and John Legend and Martha Stewart. What do John Legend and Martha Stewart have in common? There's a riddle for you. I'm going to show you, just have a little fun with before we start our teachings this morning. John Legend and Martha Stewart, what do they have in common? The riddle for us. It was in the news the last 2 weeks. These two people popped up as having something very much in common this week. So I'm going to lay that there for a minute, and then we'll come back to that. John Legend and Martha Stewart, they have something in common. I thought that would be a fun riddle to play with this morning. So in the meantime, if you can solve that riddle, let me know. press 1 in the studio. If you're in the Blog Talk Radio studio, just press 1 when you're ready to talk. I'll open up your mic and let you comment, questions, whatever you have to say. This is our time together. All you who come in and listen and participate, this is our time to explore the topic, discuss the topic, and then, of course, have a solution, because this is the female solution. So I want to start with, of course, I have several audios that I've found in YouTube University. That's where I go to learn every day, every night. I'm on YouTube every night learning new things about the body, about you name it, anything you can think of, I'm there to learn. So number one organ in the body to help us prepare for toxic explosion, in case you haven't got, is the liver. And so I am promoting detoxing the liver today and learning as much as we can about the liver. So first of all, how do you know if you have your liver's in trouble? Well, here's 10 signs that your liver is toxic.
Ten warning signs your liver is full of toxins. One of the main functions of your liver is to filter the blood coming from the digestive tract before passing the blood to the rest of your body. If your liver is weak or damaged, it could be deadly. So, how would you know if something is wrong with your liver? In this video, I will share with you 10 warning signs that you should pay attention to for your life's sake. The liver is essential to food digestion and getting rid of toxic waste from within the body. But while a healthy liver is efficient in filtering out toxins, it could quickly become overburdened, weak, or damaged. Liver failure is life-threatening, so make sure you catch any liver issues before it is too late. Watch out for these warning signs. 1. Abdominal pain. The liver itself is quite large and takes up plenty of space within the abdominal cavity. When it is burdened with toxins, it might swell and press against your other organs. When that happens, you might experience abdominal pain that you might mistake for severe bloating or indigestion, mainly because it tends to worsen after meals. 2. Feeling fatigued. It is common to feel tired when something within your body is not working correctly. But according to a 2012 study led by researchers from Egypt's esteemed Menifee University, you could also suffer from poor sleep quality when your liver is overburdened with toxins. That further leads to a state of chronic fatigue. 3. Swollen extremities. Too many toxins can affect your liver's capacity to produce albumin, which is essential to controlling fluid within your body. Consequently, fluid builds up in your legs and ankles, and even in your arms and wrists. This can also show up in the face, so seek medical attention if your face has gotten puffy. 4. Jaundiced eyes and skin. Jaundice is a condition wherein your eyes and skin turn yellow. This happens when there is a high concentration of compound called bilirubin in your blood. That is one of the most common indicators of liver damage. 5. Difficulty digesting fatty foods. The liver plays a huge role in digesting the fat you consume, but when it is full of toxins, it is not able to do so very effectively. So you will often experience abdominal pain, especially after eating fatty and oily foods. This could also come with bouts of nausea and vomiting. 6. Bad breath. It may not seem related, but your liver health can affect the smell of your breath. When your liver is not able to function properly, toxins will begin to build up not just in your liver, but also in your bloodstream. When that happens, your breath will smell foul and musty. 7. Excessive sweating. An unhealthy liver will also make you sweat in excess. That is because your liver function affects your metabolism. According to Liver Doctor, excessive sweating could be a sign that your liver is overheating. 8. Itchy skin. Itching could be an early warning sign of liver cirrhosis, where scar tissue builds up in the liver and blocks the flow of blood. Additionally, itchy skin could be a sign of damaged bile ducts in your liver. 9. Severe headaches. When the liver is overloaded with toxins, your body will be in a state of inflammation. That makes you more prone to aches and pains, which typically involve severe headaches or migraines. 10. Unexplained bruises. According to the Mayo Clinic, having a liver disease makes you more prone to bruises. That is because the liver is no longer producing enough of the proteins essential to clotting. If it gets bad enough, even the slightest touch could cause you to bruise. If you experience some of these signs and symptoms of liver disease, you must see a doctor right away. Your doctor will order a series of blood tests as well as an ultrasound, CT scan, or MRI to determine whether your liver is full of toxins. A biopsy might also be necessary to make a definite diagnosis. In most cases, a weakened liver can be treated effectively with lifestyle changes, medication, or even surgery. Following are study references we use to create this video so you can do your own research.
Okay, there's the key to all of that information. Do your own research. Please, please do your own research. If you have internet, there's no excuse for not doing your own research. It's called YouTube University. There are just thousands and thousands of teachers on YouTube. And I want to make my disclaimer, this show is not intended to replace any medical advice you may be receiving from your doctor. And if you have a condition you have not been able to treat in your own knowledge and self-help, then please see a health professional that can assist you. I'm here as a life coach with over 35 years of knowledge and experience in the holistic health field, personal experience, raising two sons. But sometimes things get out of control. And please, you know, the emergency rooms of the United States are the most excellent care places to be temporarily. There's no, as I played last week, a medical doctor just saying that the medical system is a scam, except when it comes to emergency care. You can always get some, not always, let's say most of the time, you can get the care you need for your acute condition that has driven you to the emergency room. So today we're going to explore solutions to detox the liver primarily, but when you detox your liver, you're detoxing the whole blood system because that blood is flowing through your liver and it's going to pick up any toxic waste or anything that the liver's not getting rid of or not overloaded with. That blood is going to be cleaner when it passes through your liver. So that's why we're talking about detoxing the liver with all the explosions and polluted air. We want to be ready for any type of increase. It's already, the environment's already not the purest, but we want to be ready today for any type of increase in toxicity. And I hope Mom AZ is doing okay in Arizona, because that's where the second explosion this week happened with toxic fumes. Now, the mainstream media is reporting these explosions and toxic pollution. So you have to take that with a grain of salt. Is this, are we getting the truth about this? Probably not. So that's why I'm here to share some knowledge and information about just in case. So anybody have any clues about the riddle, Martha Stewart and John Legend? What do those two have in common this week? Any clues? Any hands up? No hands up? Okay, when we come back from the break, I'm going to tell you the answer to the riddle and why it's important to know about this riddle, because these days people are exposing their characters and we want that to happen. We don't want to be worshiping anybody. No. We only worship self and the creator. So let's get into our commercial and then we'll get right back to solutions for a toxic liver.
Are you constantly arguing with your spouse? Are your children misbehaving and acting out? Is someone in your family abusing drugs? Have you been the victim of domestic violence? Are you grieving over the loss of a loved one? Let us help you restore serenity to your life. At Serenity Family Social Services, we understand that good mental health is a result of emotional well-being. Our goal is to assist you and your family in removing emotional distress and restoring harmony and balance to your lives. We offer individual, couples, and family counseling. I'm Howard Williams, CEO of Serenity Family Social Services. Call us today at 312-315-4820. That's 312-315-4820.
Do you want to live in a world without war? Join our global peace movement. Heavenly Culture World Peace Restoration of Light transcends culture, religion, ideology, and other boundaries to achieve a peaceful harmony in the global society. HWPL is committed to bringing world peace and cessation of war through peaceful dialogue between religious groups. I am Director Shin-Suk Kim of the HWPL Chicago Branch of North America. Join us for our next gathering. Call 773-580-1501 and be a part of the movement for world peace. Email us at chicagohwpl@gmail.com.
We have an opportunity to transform the whole global society in the next 50 years. 50 years from now, the Earth will be populated by a new generation of adults, many of whom are yet unborn. Our mission is to nurture them in childhood with love, guidance, and protection, and to raise them in healthy, happy families. If we impart values of compassion, generosity, and respect for fellow human beings in the next generation of children, they will create a world where people can live together in peace. This is our goal. Be a part of the transformation. Get your copy of the book, The Female Solution. Go to www.naimalatif.com. That's www.naimalatif.com.
I really do appreciate all of you who show up every Friday morning to support this show and the Female Solution and to grow in knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. That's what my intention is every Friday morning, getting up, rolling joints, helping our bodies function better, and give you more knowledge and information to take charge of your health, because the government is totally broken. The medical system is a scam. And the riddle, anybody, no hands raised, so I'm going to go ahead and give the answer to my riddle this morning. What do Martha Stewart and John Legend have in common? Now, Martha Stewart is this big personality cook who has had TV shows showing people how to cook and wrote a book and made lots of money doing that. And John Legend, a musician. Oh, my goodness, how many people love his music? He's also a writer. He writes a lot of music for a lot of these other art musicians. But this week, or the last couple of weeks, they've taken a new low in my book. These are the two celebrities I've seen in the last 2 months. In fact, the last month, I haven't seen too many celebrities promoting the jab, pushing the jab. Whoa, they've been hired by the Big P company. The big PF company, you know who we're talking about, to promote the jab. Now, after 3 years of Twilight Zone, control, you got to do this, you got to stay home, you got to shut down. After a rise in suicide rates, a rise in unemployment, rise in deaths, we all know now sudden deaths, people having heart attacks, myocarditis, the last 3 years have exposed the Big P companies big time. We're grateful. Woohoo! those of us who are still here and we survived this madness of the Twilight Zone, Big P, government push, medical system push, push, you got to do this, you got to do this, it's going to save your life, and it's safe and effective. And now we have two celebrities revealing their true nature. Congratulations, Martha and John Legend. You're in my book. You're at the bottom of the toxic waste situation. These two people are revealing themselves to be more concerned about money, obviously, or more concerned about following their puppet master, their controllers, whatever. But I just want everybody to know, keep your eye out. Don't let's just have, in my opinion, should be a boycott of anything these two people are doing, because they're drug pushers in my book. They're drug pushers with all the harm that we have seen from these products that he's now promoting with Martha. No. You're out. I do pray for his family. And he has the nerve to say in this ad that his whole family's getting the new booster. Really? How many lies can you tell, Mr. John Legend, that will be believed? And I must say, when I read the tweet, I read all the comments under this tweet that this guy posted, not one was in support of John Legend promoting a booster that his family, and smiling, saying, oh, my family's protected. Not one of all the comments I read, I must have read at least 50 comments, not one person was supporting or happy with his message. What does that say? We're waking up. We're not falling for this BS anymore. And that's why I believe you're here to take charge of your health. So I played one audio informing you about the signs of liver toxicity. That's what we're talking about. The key to preparing your body for the next toxic explosion is getting rid of the toxins inside of you so that this machine, this biological computer, can function at its best to resist any other toxic clouds of pollution. So I have two. I'm going to play the second audio on how to recognize that your liver is toxic. And I believe this is Dr. Berg. He's a frequent guest here on 9 signs of a toxic liver. Here we go.
Today we're going to talk about the 9 things that your skin can tell you about your liver. So let's go to number 1, yellow skin. That's jaundice. That is a liver problem. If your skin is slightly orange, that could also be jaundice. Or it could be that you're drinking way too much carrot juice. I remember in my late 20s, I was consuming a massive amount of carrot juice, and I literally turned orange. So that was just a pigment coming from the carrots. That's not a liver problem. All right, number 2, red palms. It's called palmar erythema, and that's just a sign that there's something wrong with your liver. Number 3, spider veins in the upper part of your body, or spider angioma, which is a dilated blood vessel. That is coming from the liver. Your liver is not able to break down the estrogen. So it's an estrogen dominant problem. You'll see this after pregnancy or if someone's taking estrogen replacement therapy. Number 4, white growths on your eyelids. That is a cholesterol buildup. Usually the person's triglycerides are high. They have low HDL, that's the good cholesterol, but it's actually not really good or bad. But because the liver controls cholesterol, having a liver problem can create that buildup. Number 5, purple flat bumps on your skin. It's called lichen planus. That is an indication that there's a liver problem. And next one, number 6, those little purple or red spots on the skin. It could be in the lower legs or it can be on the arms. It's called ecchymosis. Number 7, white scaly plaques on your scalp. Another term for that is dandruff. And that is a liver problem. And what's creating that symptom is a lack of vitamin B2 and B6. A lot of the B vitamins are in the liver. And when there's liver damage and you cannot utilize those vitamins properly, and there's a whole series of skin problems that go along with a vitamin B2 deficiency, anywhere from a basic dermatitis all the way to pellagra, which is an advanced skin problem. But junk food will not just destroy the liver, but create massive deficiencies, especially with the B vitamins, and that leads to all sorts of issues with your skin. Number 8, chicken skin, where you see those little red bumps on your hair follicles. It's called hyperkeratosis. That is a problem with the liver, and the liver is supposed to store vitamin A because it's a fat-soluble vitamin, as well as vitamin E. And when these two vitamins become deficient, you can start developing these little bumps on your hair follicles. All right, number eight, darker pigment on your knuckles, okay, in your hands. That is a liver problem, which affects your B12. Now that you know that, the next question is, what are you going to start doing or eating for the liver? For that answer, I put this video up right here. Check it out.
So we're going to go into that in a minute, the number one herb for a fatty liver. But I hope you're hearing the most important sign is through your skin about that. What's going on in your liver is going to show in your skin. And as he mentioned, yellow skin, red palms, spider veins, eyelids, purple bumps, dandruff, even dandruff. I didn't even think about that one. But yeah, dandruff, those flakes coming off are actually mucus in the form of blood, dried mucus is what really what it comes down to. Dandruff is like dried mucus coming through the skin. So pay attention to your skin. Take a look at your arms, look at your hands. I was not aware of dark knuckles. That was a new one for me. And that's mostly with melanin people. I haven't paid attention, but take a look at your knuckles. Are your knuckles darker than the rest of your skin? Time for a liver cleanse, maybe. We got some easy solutions, so don't panic. If any of these symptoms are manifesting in your skin, don't worry. Let's just take action. It's time to take action. We don't know when the next explosion is going to happen. But here is the number one herb for your liver. We don't want to have to spend a lot of money. If you don't have the budget to clean out the liver, there's some really easy, low-cost herbs and products you can buy to get started. And the cheapest or least expensive is stop eating so much food. So here's the number one herb.
The absolute best herb that you could take for liver disease, okay, is this herb called milk thistle. Now, when I'm talking about liver disease, I'm talking about three things: fatty liver, cirrhosis, which is scar tissue, and an inflamed liver. It's called hepatitis, okay? And when we talk about a fatty liver, I'm talking about both non-alcoholic fatty liver disease as well as alcoholic fatty liver disease. And by the way, as a side note, if you look at the difference between the non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and an alcoholic fatty liver disease, I mean, it's almost identical. So that's actually amazing that there's some non-alcoholic reasons why the liver gets fatty. And that all relates to one thing: insulin resistance. There's always this insulin resistance in this non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, okay? And that involves too much insulin, which comes from too much sugar, too much refined carbohydrates, and definitely with fructose, as in high fructose corn syrup. Unfortunately, more and more children are developing a fatty liver. In fact, 1 out of 10 kids has a fatty liver. And out of that 10%, 17% are developing scar tissue. Because what happens, you go through this evolution, you have fatty liver, okay, or an inflamed liver, that then turns into scar tissue, which is eventually going to turn into cirrhosis, which is the advanced form of late end stage liver disease, which is irreversible. There's a point of no return. And the other important thing you need to know about the liver is there's not a lot of symptoms with liver damage, okay, until it becomes very, very end stage, okay? So by the time you know you have damage, a lot of times it's too late. One way to know that the liver is developing fat is just to look down at your shoes right now, and if you can't see your shoes because your belly is sticking out, we know you have a fatty liver. When the liver becomes fatty, it then spills over into spaces around the liver cells, as well as around the liver itself. So you have what's called visceral fat, which is fat around the organs, as well as inside the organs too. But ectopic fat is the fat that accumulates outside the fat cell, and it just kind of spreads over because there's no more space. But regardless of what kind of liver problem you have, This is a really good remedy, okay? Milk thistle. The group of compounds in milk thistle that's producing all these wonderful effects is called silymarin. It's kind of a collective group of similar compounds that really can help your liver. Number one, and this is the biggest effect, it can actually protect you against poisons, I mean medications. Actually, poisons too, but and medications are a poison to your liver. But things like Tylenol, things like SSRIs. In fact, if you are on a medication, I highly recommend that you also at the same time take milk thistle to protect you against the damage. Also, if you're on chemotherapy, I highly recommend you take this herb. The majority of silymarin is in the seed, okay, in the seed of this weed, okay? This is what it looks like. And what you do if you wanted to harvest your own, which I recommend because it's very, very inexpensive, this prickly weed is probably in your backyard right now or in a field that you can wait until a certain time where this flower turns kind of white. And there's a 2-week window where you can actually capture the seeds. But this plant is basically going to allow the wind to spread its seeds and regrow. So what you do is you wear gloves, you take the top part of this plant off, okay? It's going to be like a white little bushy thing with a bunch of seeds, and you're going to hang it upside down and shake it into a bag or a bowl, and you're going to separate out these little things that are attached to it that look like little parachutes, okay? And you get the seeds, and you can then grind them up in a coffee grinder and put them on your salad. You can also put them in a shake, okay? Let's say you have a blueberry and a kale shake with maybe a little kefir. You can consume them in many different ways, but milk thistle is quite amazing. It protects you against poisons, you know, including medications. It can protect you against poisonous mushrooms. It can protect you against snake bites, as in poisonous snake bites. It can protect you against alcohol, so it can do a lot for you. It also has the capacity to decrease fat on your liver, as well as help you regenerate liver cells. It decreases liver enzymes, which are an indication that there's liver damage. And it does all this through increasing two very powerful antioxidants. One is SOD and the other is glutathione, okay? So they're antioxidants. The other thing that this herb will do relates to blood sugars. It helps to regulate blood sugars by lowering insulin and glucose and improving insulin resistance. And as a side note to that, that may or may not be related, it's also very, very good for depression. And milk thistle can also reduce inflammation, especially hepatitis C. Now, if you haven't seen my video on the best foods that you can eat for a fatty liver, that is the next one you should watch right here. Check it out.
Okay, so I was checking my other channels and it looks like there's no volume. I don't know what's going on.
Okay, so I was checking
my... Yeah, there we go. I'm not even... my volume for these audios not being heard on my other channel, so that's a problem. So I'm going to adjust that in the next... Hopefully adjust that in the next commercial break. But any questions, comments about that? Are you seeing any of these signs that your liver is in trouble or needs detoxing? I'm going to be sharing some information from a book by Barbara Marciniak, Path of Empowerment. I read this book about 15 years ago, and I started using a formula in here to detox my liver and detox my colon and clean my colon. And I'm still using it to this day, and I really believe this is what has helped me keep a lot of the symptoms away that you heard about the liver being toxic. Because I've been using this formula for many years. And I read it this week because I was thinking, well, how long, because of this explosion that took place, I was thinking, well, how long should I do this detox formula or this, it's called a colon cleanse drink. But anytime you clean the colon, you're going to clean the liver and all the other organs. So I'm like, how long should I do this? So I found it in her book that I read some years ago, and I want to read some of the quotes in here. This excellent, excellent health and encouraging book on the path, in the path of empowerment. But the formula says to take this for 1 month. So I am on a mission this coming, since my birthday is coming up in March, I'm going to Costa Rica next week. So I'm on a mission to keep this detox, this colon cleanse up for a month, if I can, as long as I can. So I want to give you the four ingredients, and I'll give them again in the show, four ingredients that this drink includes that will help clean your colon and your liver. Number one, liquid chlorophyll. You can find that at any health store, food store, liquid chlorophyll. And it's all of these are one tablespoon in 12 ounces of juice or and water. You mix 6 ounces of juice with 6 ounces of water, 1 tablespoon of liquid chlorophyll, 1 tablespoon of bentonite liquid. Bentonite, again, it's a clay that absorbs toxins in the body. 1 tablespoon of that in this formula. 1 tablespoon of aloe vera juice. And 1 tablespoon of psyllium hulls or psyllium powder. You probably, if you've done any cleansing, you know what psyllium. That's it. Simple, simple recipe to get your whole body detoxed and clean, and especially your liver. So I highly encourage you to consider that as one of the detox formulas that you can use over the next few weeks, days. I mean, it's a new year, new divine energy, but new pollution is what we're seeing. So let me go to the phones before we go to the break, and let's hear from you in Blog Talk Radio Studio, 773-977. Your mic is open.
Well, good morning to all. This is Lois in Chicago, and oh, my heart goes out today because this is exactly what the people need to know. You know, the doctors have been abusing and misusing our people for so, so long. And it's all wrapped up with the court system and the medical system. And, you know, we don't have any recourse. Most of the people, I believe, who are listening to us today, I believe that, and all over the world, they're going to these hospitals. They're being treated. They're going through chemotherapy and radiation and all those things, and they don't even know if they're being treated by a doctor or a resident. Claire Mae Trask, my dear mother, who died in 2002 at Loyola Medical Center from a resident puncturing her liver with a stent, and the resident was unattended. And they couldn't find out who he was until my mother suffered for about 7 or 8 days. Then I had another situation. And, I mean, all of these things are documented under the death of Clara Trask at Loyola Medical Center. These things have been going on. I remember back in, Cynthia Stitwell, she was about 3 months old, my sister's daughter. Mm-hmm. And Presbyterian St. Luke's Hospital said, oh, she has jaundice. We're going to have to keep her in the hospital and what have you. So we were young. We were in our 20s and what have you. But I happened to go to another doctor, and the doctor, a friend of the family, he said, well, if she has jaundice, she says, go to the doctor and ask them if she has crystals in her urine. He said, that's a sign of jaundice. And he said her skin would be yellow and her eyes would be yellow. So we went back to Presbyterian St. Luke. And we asked for that information. And she had no crystals in her urine. Her eyes were not yellow. So my sister took her out of the bed. She took Cynthia Stitwell out of the bed. And Cynthia Stitwell is, 52 years old to this day and never suffered with jaundice, living in Washington, D.C., as we see. So these doctors, and Troy Donahue Trask, so let's talk, you know, how they gave him dialysis and life support machine 9 times after he died. You know, these hospitals don't care. My mother always said, if you don't have a temperature, do not go to these doctors, because they're going to give you something and you're going to have to come back with them. Once they give you the medicine to mess up your liver and your kidney, your heart, then they have us. And no, these shots are doing it. And go on, we had to keep on telling it. keep on telling it because this is what God wants his people to know. This is a racket out here. This is about money. It's not about us. We have to love one another because they don't love us. Thank you. Thank you for this time. This is Lois in Chicago.
Wow. Lois, you've really said a lot about the experience that,
wow,
and I'm like hearing my voice because that's the only thing we can hear on YouTube and Facebook is my voice, unfortunately. But you said a lot about the experiences we have in the medical system that really can anger us because it hurts and causes suffering, as you explained with your mom and other people. And so this is why I do what I do, is that we can make better decisions for our life and our children's lives. You heard, if you heard Dr. Berg, he said fatty liver disease is rampant in children right now. That's like crazy. Fatty liver disease? But yes, when I look at all the junk food that's out there and even what my grandchildren are allowed to eat from their father and their mother, it's like, oh my goodness, we're in trouble. We got to really stay on top of sharing your experience, for one, Lois, and helping people see the consequences of submitting to a system that really is not about healing or health. It's about making money. I think you would agree that their primary objective is to make money. They're a business. The medical system is a business that has to make a profit to stay afloat, to stay in business, like any business. And so the primary concern is not in the system. Now, you might have nurses and doctors who are very caring and who really got into those fields to help people get well and do things for them. But the system overrules any good deeds that these nurses or doctors want to do other than holding hand and talking nicely to people. But, yeah, the system is broken. And so we're faced now with choices that are beyond our control sometimes when trains derail with toxic chemicals in them and spread them all over the community. And now fish are dying, animals are dying, the rivers are being polluted even more. So what do? We take action. We respond. In my opinion, we respond not just with anger, but we respond with action and protect our children and our families with the knowledge and the action that will strengthen these bodies to withstand and protect us from all these pollutions that we are up against. So thank you so much, Lois, for sharing that, because it just once again reveals to us the nature of these systems that we have to deal with every day and the systems that we need to come out of to protect our health and to protect our minds and our souls even. So we're going to take another break. And when we come back, I want to give you some foods. There's a list of foods that can clear your liver, help clear your liver. You might be familiar with some, but you might be surprised at some of the foods that are out there to help protect your liver and even clean your liver. So let's just get busy doing what we do to fly. First, love ourselves, and then we'll be right back after these messages.
Everything you need, what your body needs, is found in nature. So Susan Essentials doesn't do it any other way. Susan Essentials provides your employees and individuals access to over 20,000 nutritional products, and they are shipped direct to your door. Because Susan Essentials is certified in plant-based healing, we're permitted to offer you the best nutritional supplements on the planet. They're non-GMO and sustainably produced, and we take the guesswork out for you. Let Susan Essentials help you take control of your health today.
And let's take another commercial.
Hi, I'm Naima Latif, executive producer of the Female Solution Global Radio TV show. We are a part of the online network of Associated Internet Radio hosts, On Air. On Air empowers you with transformative news and interactive radio TV shows. This is such a wonderful time to be alive and to see our human family coming together as one community as a result of that powerful tool, the Internet. We can now talk directly to each other all over the world. There's no need for conflict or misunderstanding. There's no need for violence to solve our differences. We can talk to each other face to face until we reach an agreement. On Air offers a fantastic global guide to communicators from all over the world who are using their internet platforms to inspire us to strive to be our best selves in order to become the kind, compassionate, loving people we were all born to be. Once we do that, we'll see planet Earth transformed into a place of peace. Subscribe to the recommended YouTube channels, Facebook pages, and podcasts created by these voices of enlightenment. On Air provides daily news briefs and a weekly magazine to keep you abreast of events and opportunities. On Air news affiliates in television, radio, and print share information, insight, and interviews with notable personalities. Go to onaireverywhere.com for a daily dose of uplifting news. We're on air everywhere, online all the time.
The Female Solution Global Radio TV Show invites you to an invigorating conversation with our team of hosts Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Central Time. Self-Care with Jody Susan. Wednesdays, Repairing Broken Families with Naima Latif and co-host Kareem Hamid. Thursdays, Soulful Solutions with Dr. Debbie Green. And Fridays, Health and Wellbeing with Viyahta. Saturdays, tune in 12 noon to 2 p.m. Central Time. First Saturday, Success Strategies with Jana. Second Saturday, Wendy Williams Esquire on Relationships. Third Saturday, Move Around with Deborah. And fourth Saturday, Wisdom with Mama D. Join us Sundays, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Central Time for Soul Purpose Healing with Viyahta. Call in and comment 515-605-9325. Press 1 to speak to the host and be a part of the solution.
Our kids are the future and should not be left behind. One person should not decide what is the best for our 77 communities. Politicians must work together for our kids' best interests. They deserve a safe education with resources that meet every student need. Let's rebuild and restore Chicago. Vote for me for mayor of Chicago. I'm Dr. Willie Wilson, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Willie Wilson for mayor.
Today we're going to talk about the best foods to clean out your liver. Your liver is not necessarily dirty, okay? It doesn't accumulate toxins. In fact, its main function is to detoxify toxins and poisons and chemicals, but it's not a storage facility for poisons and chemicals unless you have a fatty liver, because these toxins are stored in your fat cells. Now, when your liver gets inflamed, it heals the scar tissue, and you can develop cirrhosis, and you can lose function and create all sorts of issues. But the liver itself is not a reservoir for toxins. So I want to shift my talk into the best foods to reestablish the full function of your liver, to get your liver able to detoxify at the highest level. And you can totally do this with foods. So we're going to cover all those, but I want to first talk about the different functions of the liver, okay? It has the ability to detoxify. It makes bile. Bile is a detergent to help you break down fats and extract certain nutrients from fat. Your liver is a main producer of hormones. That's right. One being IGF-1, insulin-like growth factor number one. Now, what is that? That is a very similar hormone to growth hormone. Growth hormone is made by your pituitary gland. It's sent to the liver. It works through the liver. And you can kind of consider IGF number one as an extension of growth hormone. It performs very similar functions. So it has everything to do with helping you burn fat. It's a anabolic hormone, so it helps you build muscle. It has everything to do with building proteins. And it also can help tap into your fat reserves and your stored sugar reserves for fuel. Now, your liver also makes steroid hormones, okay, like estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, vitamin D3, which, by the way, acts like a hormone in the body. In fact, it probably is a hormone, but we classify it as a vitamin. And the other sex hormone is cortisol, the main anti-inflammatory hormone in the body, the main hormone that helps you adapt to stress. So without cortisol, your body can't adapt to stress, and you're going to get really stressed out. In fact, 80% of the cortisol floating through your bloodstream originates from your liver. So all these steroid hormones come from this one thing, cholesterol. And so the liver is part of the building block of not just cholesterol, but a real key part in the creation of those hormones. And what's interesting is that people take certain drugs to block cholesterol, like statins. Well, guess what's going to happen to these hormones? You're not going to be able to make them efficiently. You're going to have all sorts of issues. And your liver makes a good portion of the cholesterol in your body. And take a wild guess what material it makes cholesterol from. If you guess dietary sugars, you are correct. So cholesterol is made from carbs. And cholesterol also makes certain proteins that transport things in the body, like cholesterol, like estrogen, like testosterone, different hormones. Because these hormones made from cholesterol can't travel that well through the blood, your liver packages them in proteins so they can be transported. So your liver has a post office function in that it is able to package certain things and send them throughout the body. Now, these proteins just don't transport certain things. They also buffer or regulate certain hormones. So if there's too much estrogen, for example, or too much cortisol, your liver will buffer that with these proteins to make sure that things are in balance. All right, so those are just some of the many functions of the liver. Your liver actually has 500 different functions. Now, before I get to the food, I just want to briefly mention the different symptoms that occur when you have damage to the liver. One would be itchiness in the body. Another one would be that your skin and the whites of the eyes turn yellow. That's called jaundice. The next one is lethargy. And then you have achy joints. So many people who are stiff and have inflammation in the joints really have a liver problem. Feeling nauseous is a big symptom of the liver. Having a lowered cognitive function could be liver related. And if you have gallstones, there's definitely a problem with the liver simply because the liver makes bile, and it's a deficiency of bile and a high level of cholesterol that makes you end up with gallstones. All right, so now let's dive into the best foods for your liver, okay? Number one, cruciferous vegetables, okay? Talking about kale, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, radish, arugula, wasabi, mustard greens. They are all cruciferous vegetables. They are very high in a natural phytonutrient called sulforaphane. And sulforaphane helps to detoxify the liver. It helps the liver to get rid of inflammation. And inflammation leads to insulin resistance. It leads to high insulin. It leads to diabetes, and it can even lead to cancer. So sulforaphane is a really important liver protective compound, and it can also help if there's fat in the liver. And with enough sulforaphane, let's say, for example, if you drank too much coffee, sulforaphane helps to quickly detoxify things like caffeine, drugs, chemicals, and even poisons. Eating cruciferous vegetables with sulforaphane can even enhance the liver to the point of having an enhanced function of the liver even 2 weeks after where you stopped eating cruciferous vegetables. So some of the effects from eating cruciferous vegetables extend into the future, even if you don't eat them. That's pretty cool. Now, if you consume cruciferous sprouts, okay, you get a major enhancement in sulforaphane, especially when we're talking about broccoli sprouts, radish sprouts, and even mustard seed sprouts. So sprouting is a very, very smart thing to do, because all you need is just a little bit of those sprouts on your salad to create a huge effect. You see, one of the key enzymes to activate sulforaphane is destroyed with heat. So if you overcook broccoli or especially cauliflower, you're not going to be able to get this full magnitude of sulforaphane unless you at the same time add a little sprouts to your salad or a little bit of raw cruciferous, or if you added a little bit of mustard to your meal, because mustard has a lot of that enzyme, because it's a cruciferous, that will help activate sulforaphane in the food that is cooked. So this is just another reason why when you have a salad, you want to add different things to it, like sprouts. And there's many other phytonutrients in cruciferous vegetables that support the liver function, which also have a lot to do with decreasing complications from diabetes and free radical damage, and improving sensitivity to insulin, and improving insulin resistance, and just supporting your blood sugars. Personally, I consume a lot of arugula in my salads. So that is just loaded with those enzymes to activate sulforaphane. I also do a lot of raw cabbage, like coleslaw, for example, and sauerkraut, which is just loaded with the enzymes to activate sulforaphane. So out of all the things you can eat, cruciferous is at the top of the list. Now, the number two item is garlic. Now, garlic is something that is loaded with sulfur, and sulfur is a wonderful thing to detoxify the liver and also act as a natural antibiotic. So it's very, very antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral. And garlic is really good for stripping off fat from your liver. And garlic also has a lot of vitamin B1 as well. I mean, garlic is just one of those superfoods. It's anti-inflammatory. It's a very powerful antioxidant. And it has huge anti-cancer properties. All right, the next one for the liver is turmeric, okay? Now, the active phytonutrient in turmeric is curcumin. Curcumin is just a powerhouse in reducing inflammation. There was someone recently who had lifelong headaches, okay? And they had to take copious amounts of Tylenol for years and years and years, and their liver has been going downhill. And so one of the key things that she did is started taking turmeric on a daily basis. And so not only did her headaches go away, but now going in the future, not having to take Tylenol, her liver is going to do much, much better. Now, one thing I want to say about the liver is that the liver is rugged. It's tough. It can bounce back unless it's completely destroyed. It only needs a little bit of itself to function. And a lot of people have destroyed a good portion of their livers, and they're able to exist and survive, which is quite amazing. But out of all the organs, the liver is the most robust. It can take a beating and it can bounce back. Now, turmeric can also detoxify heavy metals like lead, mercury, cadmium, and even arsenic. Turmeric helps to repair and regenerate liver function. Turmeric helps stabilize the mitochondria, which is why it's very anti-cancer, because the origin of cancer happens with damaged mitochondria. Turmeric is very heavily studied, especially in its ability to decrease fat on your liver. So if you combine a ketogenic diet, low carb, with intermittent fasting and turmeric and some of these other compounds, you are going to be in really good shape as far as having a healthy liver. Now, the next one on the list is beets. Beets have always been known to help detox the liver. They can help reduce liver enzymes. If the liver enzymes are high, they can help reduce them. The phytonutrients in the pigments in beets can help activate the release of bile salts, and that can help decrease the fat in your liver. But beets are hepatoprotective, which means they protect the liver cells, and they can significantly reduce inflammation in the liver. And if they can reduce inflammation in the liver, they can slow down the process of fibrosis and scar tissue and cirrhosis. Now, a question that people might have is, what about beets and being keto-friendly? Is it going to spike my blood sugars? Well, if you don't juice beets and you have them steamed, there is some carbohydrates in there. But if you add the fiber in there, that will buffer the insulin response. And so in a half a cup of beets, you're looking at about only 6.7 grams of carbs, not terribly high. Now, the next food I want to talk about is mushrooms. Now, what's so important about mushrooms with the liver? Well, mushrooms are the food that has some of the highest amount of glutathione. And glutathione is the main antioxidant for the liver, especially if you do turkey tail mushroom and oyster mushrooms and other mushrooms as well. Mushrooms are hepatoprotective. That means they protect the cells of the liver. All right, now we get to avocados. Avocados are a great thing to consume to help repair and stabilize the liver. Avocados, too, are high in glutathione that support the liver. But the main thing about avocados is all you have to do is consume one avocado a week to see significant improvements in your liver function. Avocados are very, very anti-inflammatory, and inflammation in the liver leads to so many issues, including hepatitis, including fatty liver, as well as cirrhosis. So anything that can lower inflammation would be very good for the liver. And the last thing I'm going to recommend for the liver is extra virgin olive oil. Just a very small amount. In fact, just one little teaspoon in your salad dressing can create significant improvements in liver enzymes. Extra virgin olive oil decreases fat on your liver. It improves insulin sensitivity. It reduces insulin resistance. And it's a very powerful anti-inflammatory. So there you have it, the best foods to help support a healthy liver. And if you haven't seen some of my other videos on the liver, I created a playlist for you right here. Check it out.
Okay, that was Dr. Eric Berg, and let's see. We got to get rid of echo here. I'm dealing with a audio problem right now. I don't have no audio on Facebook or YouTube. So what I have to do in the future is only use my phone to tune in to Blog Talk, because Direct Connect for some reason doesn't work anymore on StreamYard. So let me continue. I want to read to you, because the only voice that's being heard on YouTube is mine, not the audios I'm playing. So maybe that's a sign for me to just go to my voice. This is a book I highly, highly recommend, Barbara Marciniak. I rarely recommend books on this show, but I have a full library of books, and I had even more books when I moved into my tiny house on wheels, 8x20, 160 square feet. I had to get rid of probably over 100 books because they wouldn't fit. So I got my books down to maybe 50. And so I still have those 50 here in my small space. And this is one of my favorite all-time books. I mean, this book is so full of mind, body, spirit balancing. Barbara Marciniak, Path of Empowerment. That's the key to preparing your body for the next topic, a toxic explosion, is to have full balance mind, body, spirit. Where number one, you don't go into fear and panic and anxiety, which I think you may have heard is going to affect your cortisol levels and your adrenal glands. So there needs to be a peace about you when these explosions show up and they create all this toxic pollution. So this book is one of the best I would recommend to help you balance mind, body, spirit in times of chaos and turmoil. And Path of Empowerment, it's Palladian wisdom for a world in chaos. Perfect. And this book was published 1948. No, that's her birth date. Barbara was born in 2004. 2004, this book was written. So it's almost 20 years old. Full of just so much wisdom for, as it says, a world in chaos. Palladian, if you're not familiar with Palladium, those are like angelic forces that are everywhere in our universe. This is a book that creative solutions for changing beliefs, reclaiming your power, and creating a world of unlimited possibilities. So I read to you, and out of this book, out of the Palladian wisdom that she channels, came the information about the colon cleanse drink, the liquid chlorophyll, the aloe vera, the bentonite, and psyllium, four ingredients that if you take this formula for a whole month, you're going to get a cleaner bloodstream, a healthier liver, cleaner liver. Your whole body is going to be in a stronger position to offset the pollutions and toxins that are floating around in our system, in our environment. So I want to just read a few lines from this book to maybe stimulate your interest in getting a copy of this book to help you in these times of chaos, because that's what we're in. And I bought this book about 15 years ago, and I have so many red outlines and highlights in this book that I was trying to find the formula and figure, okay, 1 month on that colon cleanse formula, and that is what it will bring you to a whole new level of health if you can do a month on that formula. Even 2 weeks, a week, minimum 1 week, I would say, on that formula, reducing the processed foods and all the other junk foods that we, especially sugar, the drug of choice today. We are all addicted to sugar. Let's just admit it. So the only way I'm finding, number one, to get off my addiction is don't have it in the house. Don't have it as a temptation. And don't have processed foods in my house with sugar in them. So I load up my cupboard with dates and currants and lots of fruit now, so that at night, 12 o'clock, not 12, but usually at 9 or 10 o'clock at night is when my cravings start, like I need something to snack on. I'm looking for something sweet. The only thing there is a piece of fruit or a date, or that's what I'm going for right now instead of the cakes, cookies, whatever we have, you get used to. So I see a caller as press one, so let me open up the mic of our caller. And I'm welcoming your comments today. How's your liver? How's the state of your liver out there? Are your livers in good health? After hearing all the symptoms of a toxic liver, is everybody in a state of health with their liver? If not, why not? And are you ready to start on a new adventure of detoxing your liver and tuning, getting a tune-up for this sacred temple? So let me open up the mic. 312-597. Your mic is open. Welcome.
Good morning. This is Koofy James.
Koofy James, how you doing, Koofy? Are you ready for the next toxic explosion?
What was the first?
We've had two on both sides of the country, one in Ohio, one in Arizona so far. And even, you know, all the things that UFO sightings, they're distracting us with so much so much news right now that you need to be focused. Number one, fly. First, love yourself and take care of your temple. Strengthen it for whatever is to come. So that's the message today. And we're focused on the liver because the liver is key to help you handle the pollution and all the other things coming.
Well, first thing, there is no chaos going on that hasn't been here already. What's going on has been going on all along. It just pretty much in your face. And
mainstream media is putting it in our face. You're absolutely right.
Yeah, I mean, it's just whether or not you give it your attention. That's how I look at it. You know, people call me, man, did you hear about this? Did you hear about that? I go, no. I grew up in a day where we had newspapers, so we didn't know what was going on around the world unless you know, it's now you know what's going on around the world. Secondly, our kidney, it's kind of funny. I saw this one diagram picture that had like pictures of food, you know, natural food, and it had like the body, you know, the kidney, the heart, and the kidney is shaped like a cashew.
Right.
You know, a cashew nut. Hello? Yeah.
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, the kidney is shaped like a cashew nut. And so I drink cashew milk, which helps. It's Mother Nature's milk. You know, the biggest thing, we wouldn't have to detox so much if you didn't put in chemicals in your body. If you just maintain and watch every time you put something in your body that was natural and non-chemical, you wouldn't have any problem with your body anymore. You'll stay young. You'll stay youthful. You'll stay fit. But the problem is people are addicted to, like I said, sugar and stuff like that. Although sugar is more addictive than cocaine. You know, so if you're keeping up with your what you're ingesting in your body, then natural foods is like a detox.
Right.
You know,
right. If
I'm eating watermelon with seeds, from lemon juice all the time, I'm actually every day I'm cleaning my system out, giving it the nutrients that it needs. So that's just a part of a lifestyle. And if you know, you don't have to do it, you know, when you're doing it, you just do it every day. It's just a part of your regimen. This is a part of, you know, I'm putting in herbs in my body all the time and watching what I eat, the fast food out here, watching when I eat fast food, I get sick, you know. My body rejects it, so I don't stop at fast food places because I know how it's going to make me feel. You know, you can determine what you put in your body on how it makes you feel after you eat it. You know, when a cat or a dog eats something that makes it sick, it naturally goes outside and eats some grass. Nobody told it to do that. A dog will go outside and start eating the green grass off the ground when it's still sick. A cat would do the same thing. You know, so, you know, like I said, all this that you think is going on is going on in other people's mind. This is a mind control effort that has captured millions and millions and millions of people's mind. You know, remember the end of the world and Jesus coming back and all this going on and people worry. If you connect to that stuff, you're going to worry. People love sometimes to worry. They love trauma. It kind of like gets their blood going, you know. I don't pay it no attention. My mama taught me well. Even when civil rights was going on, and this is a secret. This is really, really deep. In civil rights, the elders didn't even participate in it. It was the young people who participated in it. I want to sit at the, uh, the, the I want to sit at the restaurant. I want to drink the white water fountain. I want to do this. It was a youth who they captured the youth mind. Our elders were like, boy, sit down. Don't watch my look. Don't get off into that. The elders did not participate in the civil rights struggle. Now do your research on that one. That is so phenomenal. It was the youth that they captured. And it is the youth that they're capturing right now who are gullible, don't have a parental guidance in their life. I'm so happy that I talk to my daughter a lot. She got 3.4 grade point average. She get a full ride scholarships, and I tell her all what's going on, and she goes, Daddy, I know. It's a bunch of game out here. I'm not paying no attention to it.
Hallelujah.
They're
hallelujah.
Capturing the youth mind.
Look, yes, we got to go to commercial break, my last commercial break. I'm over time, but thank you for sharing that, because you're absolutely right, Kufi. It's the youth that are going to make a difference in the next few years to change our society. And elders,
It's the elders. Yes. The youth is followed. The youth is following me. I'm counseling the youth right now on my Facebook page. They're regurgitating what I'm giving them, and we have to stay. We have to keep that relationship going. The youth is not going to save the world. I'm sorry. I can't save the world. No, you don't save the world and me. You know who saved the world and me? My grandmama and her grandmama. Okay,
We got to go to a break, so I'm going to come back to you maybe after the break. But here's the deal. The way I see it in my world, my grandchildren are the ones who are going to change the world, because what I see in them is a different belief system, especially about race. They're not concerned about racism and all these this drama that we've been seeing with older people and young and all that. But the youth are going to change the world in the way they respond to what we teach them. Yes, we all play a role in changing this earth. The elders play a role if we're conscious, and the youth play a role if they're conscious. So if we work together, we can bring about the changes that are needed. People are waking up. As I said, the fact that only two celebrities I've seen so far, Martha Stewart and John Legend, the only ones this week that I've seen pushing the jab, that's a big improvement than the last 2-3 years, where all these celebrities, Roland Martin Jesse Jackson, everybody pushing the jab. Now, only two so far, and we need to just pay attention to those who are still unconscious and don't support what they do, so they understand we're not putting up with that anymore. So we'll be right back after this break. I'm going to read from this really good book, Path of Empowerment, and show you on many levels how you can walk forward with the youth. We can't exclude them. They're teaching us, number one, how to be patient and how to guide them with wisdom. Many of these youth don't have any wisdom, but if you have wisdom, how about you work with the youth that don't and guide them, as Kufi is doing with his children, guiding them into the unity and harmony that we need a better earth. Let's work together. So we'll be right back after this.
Crime in Chicago continues to increase. Communities and politicians must come together to make a change. No one person can solve these problems by themselves, but I believe together we can make progress. Let's provide job training, economic growth, and invest into our 77 community. Let's rebuild and restore Chicago. Vote for me for mayor of Chicago. I'm Dr. Willie Wilson, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Willie Wilson for Mayor.
Our kids are the future and should not be left behind. One person should not decide what is the best for our 77 communities. Politicians must work together for our kids' best interests. They deserve a safe education with resources that meet every student need. Let's rebuild and restore Chicago. Vote for me for mayor of Chicago. I'm Dr. Willie Wilson, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Willie Wilson for Mayor.
Is Monday morning a struggle to get out of bed, into the swing of things? Well, don't worry, you are not alone. Join us for thought-provoking, stimulating and mindful conversations on higher learning with Zelda Speaks for your Monday morning mindfulness session on Blog Talk Radio, The Female Solution, Mondays 7:30 until 9 a.m. Be sure and send your ideas, thoughts, comments, and suggestions. Also, if you'd like to be a guest on the show, visit ZeldaSpeaks.com and send us your info. We'd love to have you. Experience mindfulness moments with the mindfulness/stress relief coach, Zelda Speaks. And thanks for sharing the mindfulness moment tip of the day. Stay on purpose, stay empowered, and stay tuned to your next session of Mindfulness on Higher Learning with Zelda Speaks. Make it a mindful day. And thanks for listening.
Tune in to Soulful Solutions with Dr. Debbie Green on Thursdays at 7 a.m. Central Standard Time and 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to hear great topics and stories on grief and turn it into victory. Join Dr. Debbie Green to listen to stories of triumph and learn how to overcome. You are not alone in your life, and there is hope in the darkest hour. This is your time to learn strategies and solutions to improve your life. It's your time. So join Dr. Debbie Green with Soulful Solutions and call in on Thursday at 7 a.m. Central Standard Time and 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time at 515-605-9325 with comments and questions. Look to hear from you real soon.
For my Facebook friends, they can't really hear the audios I'm playing. So I'm the only one who can be heard on Facebook, not my audio. So I do have a really important audio I want to play. So I'm just focusing on those of you who are in the Blog Talk studio today and in giving you the information that I want you to have to prepare you for whatever, because we never know what's coming up next. And so many people are glued to their devices. I won't even say TVs. People are not watching TV as much as they're in the device of cell phones in their face. And believe me, when I go to Costa Rica next week for 8 days, my phone is going to stay in the room. I'm not going to be carrying my phone around Costa Rica. I'm going to be detoxing from my phone and all the pollution of America and get in by the beach. So that's what I encourage you to do. Every place you live, there's a detox location where you can spend time with the trees. Like Kufi was sharing, we need to get out in nature. That's part of the solution to detoxing your body, is to be in nature. And I'm going to read from this book in a minute. I have another caller. And Kufi is absolutely right. He is sharing his journey with his children, with himself. And everything he's doing is helping him have a strong body. And each one of us can make the decisions and choices that will strengthen our temple in the way that's best for you. And the children, there's a mixture of generation X, Y, Z who are out there who are exploring their genders, their diets, their lifestyle, whatever. But it's really important for elders to be strong and healthy these days so that we can guide all these XYZ generations to become more conscious. And I'm telling you, there are a lot of conscious youth out there. We just got to keep our antennas up. When you see them, let's nurture them, encourage them, motivate them. My 6 and 8-year-old grandchildren are becoming more and more conscious. So that's why grandma is always ready to guide them into more consciousness. That's what it's all about. Let me open the mic to 312-848. Your mic is open. Thank you for joining me.
You're welcome. This is Rashida from Chicago. I have
Hi,
question.
Rashida. Yes,
Hi,
ma'am.
How are you?
Good, thanks.
Do you have a remedy for people who have respiratory problems?
Oh, there's plenty of You know, one remedy is not the solution, but there's a lifestyle change that has to occur for a respiratory problem, because it's not just physical. When in my experience over the last 35 years of asthma or any breathing issues, is there's a deep emotional root to that, which I want to go into a little bit in this book. But there's a deep emotional root to it. So that's why tapping, Maika and I both promote tapping to get to the root of the emotional root first. And then there's all kinds of herbs that can help with that. Now, is it an asthma related or what type of respiratory? Because there's several respiratory health challenges. What type of respiratory are we talking about?
Chronic obstruction, pulmonary disease, like that, on that level. But I'm mostly interested in knowing the herbs. I'm not on a respirator, oxygen or anything like that. But when I was younger, when I was a baby, I had asthma. And as I grew wiser and healthier, I didn't have that anymore. But I was helping the homeless and occupancy of housing, and there was a water explosion, and I stayed in the unit, and mold set up, and ever since then, I have had, you know, not a real bad problem with it, but when I catch a cold or when I get stressed, it acts up. So I've been to the doctor, you know, to get diagnostics done, but I'm okay as far as he could say. But whenever I get a cold, you know, the mucus, it comes up all the time when I cough. And
That's a good thing, though. But that's really a good thing if you're coughing up the mucus and it's not a dry cough. It's better to be having mucus coming up instead of just a dry cough when nothing's expelling. So that's not really a bad thing if you're coughing up mucus. What you have to do, Rashida, is assist the process. Your body knows what to do to balance out the trauma that you experienced with that explosion. So you're saying you experienced a trauma. In German New Medicine, that's the beginning of usually disease or health problems, because the reaction that we have to that trauma is to take a deep breath and hold our breath and not breathe through the trauma in many ways. So what part of the problem, Louise Hay, for instance, let me just read, Heal Your Body. Louise Hay says, respiratory ailments, whether it's bronchitis, colds, coughs, influenza, have to do with the fear of taking in life fully. Now, just process for a minute. And the resolution she brings, or the most beneficial affirmations, she says, are, I am safe, I love my life. If you're repeating that mantra, that affirmation over, I am safe, I love my life, instead of being in fear of taking in the life fully, that's the beginning of healing the whole trauma that you went through, the process. And then doing some tapping, EFT, emotional freedom techniques, to let go of the fear of that trauma and what it occurred. Now, your body is doing exactly what it needs to do to help you overcome that. It's bringing up mucus. Because if you have mucus in there, that's part of the breathing, the respiratory problem, is all that mucus is interfering with you taking in life fully and breathing in and out in a clean environment, let's say. The mold problem is challenging. Anybody who I've heard who has suffered from being in a mold environment, they have a long journey to healing, but they do get over it if they have the right environment to help them get rid of the mucus and heal the lungs, because you're in the process now of healing your lungs, your tissues, your breath, all that's being healed if you're coughing up mucus. But you've got to assist it. Number one, stop not eating processed foods. bringing in more juices, the type of food that we just heard, the beet juice. Lemons and limes are wonderful for helping get rid of the mucus. Bringing those lemons and limes every morning in hot water will help you bring up that mucus. That's what you want to do. You want to bring up the mucus and get it out of your system. And then the lungs and everything will heal faster when you can get that mucus. Even a colonic or enemas. Have you ever done colonics or enemas?
Yes. And the good thing about the mucus is that it's clear. It's not, you know, real puffy or blood or anything. So, but yes, I have done that before.
Yeah, but you're right. The color of the mucus is what tells you how serious it is. If it's clear, that's a good sign that it's just regular process, body detox processing. If you have green mucus, you have an infection. You have a serious infection if your mucus is green. If your mucus is yellow, that's bacteria coming out of your body. And if it's red with blood in it, that's even more serious, where you have to really consider whether you need a health professional to help you heal whatever's bringing up bloody mucus. Because bloody mucus is serious. I'm not, don't take that for granted. But if you're going, if you can just get into a meditative, peaceful, detox, fasting state, you can even help get rid of the, heal the bloody mucus, as long as it's not going long term. You don't want to have bloody mucus for weeks and weeks. That's not good at all, or even days. But you can help your body along in this process of excreting all the mucus, blood, green, yellow, whatever, by fasting, number one, and then getting out and breathing fresh, good oxygen with trees and nature. Do you have, I know you're in Chicago, but do you have any locations where you can just get out and breathe fresh air with tree, lots of trees and nature?
Ever since I was a child, I would go to the conservatory, and the conservatory, it has all the beautiful plants and greenery around it. So, yes.
Absolutely. So you want to be in a, just get into a healthier environment and stop eating. So the stem cells, which repair, let's say stem cells, you're going to repair those lungs, repair whatever you need to repair. Those stem cells are produced when you're fasting. The information that I've heard and read is that 72 hours of fasting, and that doesn't necessarily mean going without food for 3 days. That's like 3 days of no eat. But it reducing what you're putting, consuming in your body, that gives your body a chance to produce stem cells. And that's what is very popular these days. People looking for stem cells to repair everything and anything, but really just fasting for at least 72 hours. If you can do a seven, that's going to produce the most stem cells. But I'm producing stem cells because I don't eat any solid food now till 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I get up with lemon, lime water in the morning. At 12, I make a smoothie that's all liquid and berries and cranberries, strawberries. And then I might drink some tea. Coconut water is in there. And then 3 o'clock, I start eating solid foods. And I haven't lost 1 pound. In fact, I've gained weight. I've gained a pound or two, which is always my goal. I don't need to lose weight because I'm thin already. But I'm gaining weight because I've reduced the amount of time I'm putting consuming food, and I'm letting the stem cells be produced to repair whatever needs to repair, which is going to make your whole system work better, Rashida. When you are fasting for a period of time during the day, let's just say you have 12 hours. You go to bed at 12 midnight. You don't eat till 12 the next day. That's 12 hours of fasting for your body to produce stem cells to repair what needs to be repaired. Now, you could go longer than 12 hours. Let's say you stop eating at 11 at night. You get up. You don't eat. You don't do anything till 2 or 3 in the afternoon. But you're drinking and you're providing nutrients in other ways, outside, for instance, then your body's producing stem cells all that time. that you are not eating, so that when you do eat, your digestion will be better.
That's good to know, because I will be fasting the beginning of next month, so that's good to know.
So I hope that helps you, but be sure
and
I know you'll be prayerful about it and spend time deep breathing. That's, to me, a solution to any type of acute health challenge, is to get in a place where you can do deep breathing with trees and grass and birds and nature. So I want to just share for the couple of minutes we have left this powerful book, Path of Empowerment, Palladian Wisdom for a World in Chaos. We are in chaos because our government needs to change. We got celebrity. Thank goodness we don't have as many celebrities trying to motivate people to take a toxic poison jab. Only two this week so far. So stay away from John Legend and Martha Stewart's advice. They're not doing anything for your benefit. Even his music, I don't listen to much of it anyway, but I'm turning him off for now. So here's some words from Path of Empowerment. It is most important for you to accept that you are a powerful being. This is from page 11 on Path of Empowerment. Your physical body serves as your own intimate example of the impeccable design of life, intricate and wondrous organization of your cells, bones, and organs illustrates a vast network of cooperation that mirrors back to you the primary nature of existence. By design, you are a fine achievement, a organic computer that is fully capable of consciously experiencing the different levels of your own reality as well as many others. Your state of awareness then determines how you respond to the dramas of life you have created. You have the free will to choose what you will. What you will sow will be yours to harvest. With a good measure of faith, trust, and desire, augmented with a large dose of cosmic knowledge as well as common sense, you can certainly learn to focus your attention, be very clear about your intention, and manifest what you want in life. Self-empowerment is a worthy achievement in my reality, although it is not necessarily an easy state of mind to achieve. Like any skill, it must be focused upon and developed and called into being. Yet once encouraged to awaken, self-empowerment blossoms and grows on its own, much like a hardy heirloom plant that thrives and flourishes season after season. Nestled in the depths of your cells are the memories and records of all of your ancestors, some of whom same issues you are encountering today. Our ancestors didn't deal with what we're encountering today. This is Meet My Voice. Our ancestors were lynched and whipped and beaten and murdered and so much more. Horrific things happened to our ancestors. What we are dealing with today is just totally different. The challenges are different. They're absolutely present, but they're nothing like what our ancestors went through, whether they came over here on slave ships or they were in the Trail of Tears with Native Americans. We are not dealing with the same things our ancestors dealt with, but I truly believe our ancestors are here to help us. And my grandchildren demonstrated yesterday in this wax museum of Black history greats that they can accomplish anything if they set their mind and their intentions to doing that, accomplishing the best. And that's what we're all here to do. And finally, power is a test of character, and the choice is always yours. In one small cell in our body, there's more potential power than you could use in your entire lifetime. However, global consciousness must first demonstrate its acceptance of ultimate responsibility for handling that kind of power before the gates to the mysteries of the multiverse are open. We are so blessed. We are so unique right now where we are in history. We were born for such a time as this, as they say, and all we have to do is rev up the power within us. Like it says, every cell in our body is here to help us do what we came to do, and that's to save Mother Earth, save this planet, and become the best we can do, and help the generation XYZ, whatever. We as elders, most of my audience is usually elders, so I'm encouraging you, be strong, build up your bodies, re-sculpture your bodies. It's never too late. I'm re-sculpturing my body with weights and workouts and all that because we need to. Our youth need us. Our youth need us every day to be healthy, strong, wise, and guide them so that they come out of all this confusion. This confusion is generated and perpetuated by a big government, big medical system, and Hollywood.
Come to the end of our show today.
Entertainment forces that are not being promoted for our good. So thank you so much. I hope you share this message. Facebook. I'm sorry. Apologize. Facebook didn't get all the audios I played, but you can go to the blogtalkradio.com /female solution to hear all the audios for the last hours that I did on Facebook and my YouTube channel. So I'll put a message on there for them to go to Blog Talk Radio, the Female Solution, for this particular show. And be sure so to we're going to say book, farewell, and everybody enjoy the day. It's another summer day in Florida. I'm sending lots of sun to my folks in Chicago. And just have a view, no matter the weather, just get out and get some sun if you can. And share this message to those who need to hear it.
In China,
India, Zanyaba, Japan, Arigato, Korea, Kamsahamnida, Russia, Spasiba, Germany, Danke, Poland, Jeong Kujung, France, Merci, Spain, Gracias, Italy, Grazie, Egypt, Shukran, Ghana, Medasi, Nigeria, Eshe, South Africa, Ngiyabonga, Senegal, Geret, Kenya, Asante, Israel, Toda, Pakistan, Shukriya, Afghanistan, Tashakor, Saudi Arabia, Shukran, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Thank you, and may peace be upon you and the mercy of God.
Friends, Satnam and Namaste. Love you. Have a beautiful day.